So the battery, 12 volt, 9 amp hour battery. Technically that's 9,000 milliamp hours of capacity. In reality, 7,000 milliamp hours of capacity. The gate uses, in standby mode, 4.5 milliamps every hour. So seemingly a great deal of extra power there. With a new battery, this barrier will go up and down 5,000 times without any help from the solar. So we have the backup, but it does rely, if it's going to keep going for months, it does rely on solar input. Now the trouble is with lead acid batteries, if they do run down and are left in a rundown state for any length of time, and by that I mean a few days, two or three, then they will deteriorate and they'll never get back to full capacity again. So it's a good idea to, if you think the gate is not operating correctly, in other words it's going slowly as opposed to its normal speed, as demonstrated here, it means it's getting up for 4 seconds, thereabouts. If it's taking say 5 or 6 seconds to get to lift, then the chances are the battery is under power. Either just not got capacity, or it's just generally run down and needs charging. Lead acid batteries are used by us and by others because they are easy to charge by solar panels. The trouble is with other types of batteries, such as NiCad, it takes quite a bit more power from the solar panel to cross the bridge to start powering the battery. Lead acid batteries really do absorb whatever's put into them. So in a low output, low input system, at the moment, we have to stay with lead acid batteries despite their failings. And one of their major failings is it's very difficult to tell when it's charged or how much charge is in it. Simply putting a voltmeter on really tells you nothing. And I shall just demonstrate that here. The battery in this gate is currently measuring 12.73 volts, 12.74. That's good, that's about where it should be. Anything over 12.2 is fine, anything under 12.2 should be charged. Simple rule, anything under 12 and left there for any length of time, chances are you spoil the battery. However, show the difficulty. This battery is measuring 12.96 because it's recently come off charge. So I think that's a good battery. I put it on the gate and bear in mind this battery is the same type as the one I've just taken off. There's a click, gate works, turns on. Press the button to get the gate to lift. Can't do it. The reason it can't do it is because once this battery is under load, its voltage has crashed down to about 4 or 5 volts. It's got a spoilt cell or two in it. So you saw it's charging, it appeared to be charged, and the battery charger would say that it had been charged, when in fact it was no good. So how do you tell the difference? Well, there's no easy way, but the only practical way is to actually measure it while the gate is trying to lift. So, turn this off. Put this on here. Where are we now? 12.87. I'm going to operate the gate now while I'm measuring. So see what happens to the voltage when I do that. Turn the gate on would help. You see it's gone down to 5-6 volts. The gate is just about lifting. 8 or 9 volts. You know, it can work. The gate will work down to 9 volts. But you see it went a lot slower. Clues are there. Doesn't just give up. But it's not really going now. 6-7 volts, it's trying, but it can't really do it. That's the point. That battery checked out on a voltmeter, fine. In reality, it's not. So how best to deal with this? Well, number one, keep the batteries charged. If the gate slows down, put the battery on charge and leave it on charge for 12 hours overnight, regardless of whether the battery charger itself has a light on or a light off. Leave it on for 12 hours. Secondly, if there's any doubt about a battery, in other words, you've just charged it, you've put it on a gate, and after 2 or 3 days it doesn't seem to be working very well, I'm afraid the battery needs binning and you need to put a new one on. Save you a lot of trouble in the long run. A new battery will keep this gate going for well over a month without much solar help at all. So if it's only lasting 3 or 4 days, the battery's had it. The gate is all right. So we'll leave it there for the moment, and we'll now move on to using the charger itself. Battery charging. Well, this is our standard charger, 720 milliamp hour at full charge. We use 9 amp hour batteries, so essentially 12 hours will take a discharged battery to full charge, assuming there's no damage to the battery. Goes in the standard UK 240 volt plug. Turn it on at the mains and you'll see the light comes on, seemingly to indicate that the battery's charged when there's no battery in attached. So we'll attach a battery now, black to black and red to red. Now you'll see here the charge light was off and then came on. It is indicating this battery is fully charged, and it is, recently come off charge. I would, however, if you get a battery like this that come you've had it working and it indicates it's full charged, I would still leave it on overnight, give it a 12 hour charge. This will go into float mode and it'll just keep topping that battery up and give it a little bit more. No problem with leaving it on overnight, even with that light on. Don't leave it on for too long, but certainly overnight or even a full day is fine. If I put these black on black and red to red on this battery, you see the light has gone out. I know this battery is discharged and it will need a 12 hour charge to come up to spec. So that's fine.